What's going on, everybody? Cole Simonson here with Ram. And today is part three of how to plan your Western hunt. So, I kind of was struggling with this part three here. And so I reached out to a couple Facebook groups, asked them a couple questions, and got some answers from them on what they wanted to know about planning a Western hunt. Some of them were really good questions, and some of them were really stupid, so I left those ones out. But today, it kind of gave me an idea of what people wanted to hear, and a lot of the questions were based around preparedness when you come out west. So that's what today's video is about, is preparedness. And we'll probably break this down into two pieces. One, the preparedness physically and mentally, and two, the preparedness into gear and the logistics of actually planning your hunt. So today is just gonna be the quick and easy physical and mental preparedness. And next week will be our gear and how to use it and what to plan for and prepare for. So let's get started. But before we do, if you guys have any questions or video topics you want to hear about, put them in the comments down below. I'd really want to hear what you guys have to say. And if you are liking this video series, don't forget to smash the thumbs up button. Helps me out a ton. And I mean, who doesn't like a good video? So here we go. And let's just start with the easy one, which is physical preparedness. What it takes to physically get prepared to come out west and have a successful hunt. Now, when we're talking physical preparedness, we have to go way back to part one, which I'll link up here, and talk about what style of hunting we're doing. So you might have to be a little bit less physically in shape if you're just doing a base camp hunt with an outfitter. You know, they have horses, they have packers and all that stuff for you. So you might just have to be a little bit less physically prepared. But if you're doing a do-it-yourself hunt, backcountry, you're way back there, you have to be in shape, especially at our high elevations out here. So first things first is what I highly recommend is getting on a solid diet. The diet is the most important part of your physical health. So there's so many programs out there to give you a good diet. I personally have used Coach Matt Harsky in the past. He's a good friend of mine, absolutely fantastic coach, great guy. I'm pretty sure you can still get a online training from him. Just look up Matt Harsky on Google. I know one of the supplement companies I use, First Form, they have a lot of training programs themselves. And the one I'm personally trying out right now is Athlene X from Jeff Cavalier. If you haven't seen his YouTube videos, he is also a very good trainer and a very good coach. So that's just kind of a good base to start with, especially with your nutrition, because these guys have all studied nutrition for years. They know exactly what you need daily to keep your body up and running. Next, you'd want to find yourself a good program, physical program. So I necessarily wouldn't recommend a heavy bodybuilding program because hunters need their endurance. More weight and muscle you put on, your endurance and stamina goes down a little bit. So I'd like to stay in the mix. You know, I don't want to just do straight cardio all the time, but I also don't want to just do no cardio and no endurance training. So that being said, find yourself a good mixture of workouts. You know, I don't personally do it, but I know a lot of people like CrossFit. I'm not a fan of CrossFit, but it is a very good workout. So just get yourself physically prepared. Make sure that you're not overweight, out of shape. Even if you just hike, you know, 2-3 miles a day with a 30-pound, 40-pound pack, or just keep working your pack up, that is a great way to stay in shape and get ready for Western hunts. And if you're doing that, make sure you have hills. You'll be climbing a lot of those. So that is pretty much just the basics of our physical training when it comes to the Western states. No matter how hard you train, no matter what you do, as soon as you hit that elevation, especially if you're from the lower country, you know, back east, as soon as you hit that high elevation, it takes it out of you. Especially if you're doing high country elk or mule deer hunts, or even sheep hunts. I mean, you're gonna struggle, trust me, for at least for the first few days until your body gets used to the elevation. I'm at 5,000 feet right now, and it does, even when I start my training up in the mountains, hiking and fishing and stuff like that, the first couple days of the year up there are absolutely rough on me, so they'll be rough on you. So be prepared for the elevation change. Now let's talk our supplements while we're actually hunting, or our supplements while we're getting physically prepared. There's so many good things you can take for your body and bad things. There's tons of research papers out there to read the best, you know, the best products on the market. My advice on those is just do your research. Try to stay away from really, really heavily induced products, a lot of unnatural stuff. I necessarily don't even take pre-workout anymore before my workouts because I just didn't like how it made me feel. But some other people love pre-workout. Some people just take caffeine, you know. And then when it comes to your proteins and stuff like that, just make sure you're getting a really healthy, clean protein. You'll spend a little bit more, but it's worth it in the end. You aren't getting junk, and you'll actually see your body start to transform. But make sure you're taking, you know, vitamins and the one I'm really bad about taking but really need is fish oil. It's great just all around, especially for backpackers and hunters. And if you're planning on a backpacking hunt, it's great for that because it helps your joints a ton. And that's also what I recommend, joint supplements other than fish oil too, especially if you're a little bit older. You know, it just, it's a fact, you know, the older you get, the more worn your joints get, the more troubles you have. So especially if you're planning a trip that is a lot of physical exertion, just being prepared earlier on with your vitamins and oils and stuff like that will make you feel very good and a lot stronger on these hunts. Ooh, coffee break. You know what? I should make a mug like Beatles Abbey Road, but with everyone packing out elk. That'd be cool. I'm gonna do it. So anyways, let's get, we covered the physical part. We covered some supplements. Real quick, actually, let's get into backcountry food. You know, if you're at a base camp and you're at a camper and stuff like that, you know, you can really pack just really whatever you want, especially if you have access to ice within a few miles, or access to a local town within, you know, half hour or so. You can really pack whatever you want. But if you're talking backcountry, let's really kind of get into that, because this is my area of, not expertise I'd say, but I've been very successful in actually narrowing down my meals to where I can keep a very light load but also last a lot of days. My absolute favorite meal, and I only pack one a day just because, one, it saves me money doing that, and two, I can actually make them last 2 days if I get the correct serving size. And that's my Mountain House meals. I really do enjoy Mountain House. They aren't as healthy and clean as some of the other ones, like Heather's Choice, and there's one other, I can't remember what it's called right now. They're very, very filling. They have a lot of carbs, a lot of protein. And at the end of the day, they are just a great morale boost in camp. especially the really good ones. My favorite one is actually chili mac and beef. And so I usually eat one of those a day, and if I'm still full, if I don't finish it that evening, I'll actually be able to warm it up in the morning and have it for breakfast, or even stretch it out the next day and have it for lunch too. So I really love my Mountain House meals. They're really lightweight, they taste delicious, easy to make up, and just at the end of the day, a great morale boost. So next, we go with our breakfasts and what we do about that. Usually I pack 2 packs of oatmeal, heat up my water and my little jet boil, and call it good. That's a really good breakfast. If you have some freeze-dried fruit, that works perfect too. And you can't forget your coffee. So Dark Timber makes some really good packs that you just, they're little like tea bag looking packs. You put them in boiling water in the morning and you have a cup of coffee, and it's really pretty good. Black Rifle Coffee also makes the same thing. They're very good too. So next we have, we covered our dinner, we covered our breakfast, which are kind of my main 2 meals I eat. But then I like to snack through the day. My favorite snack is, I mix peanut butter pretzels with a bunch of different nuts. So I get some good fats in. And then I just have the pretzels with peanut butter because I love pretzels with peanut butter. And along with that, my main lunch for the day is either leftover Mountain House or tuna packs. I love tuna packs. They are great. They're lightweight, full of protein, have omega-3s in them, which are very good for you. And so it just makes, it makes a really good lunch. Along with that, I carry ramen noodles too, just to kind of break up the monotony of the same food every day. I'll crush up ramen noodles for lunch, or crush up ramen noodles for dinner, mix it with Mountain House, or mix it with tuna, stuff like that. So ramen noodles are kind of my my different food I use to really help me break up the monotony of eating the same thing over and over again. So that kind of rounds out what I eat for my backcountry hunts. Extremely lightweight, extremely, well, not extremely healthy, but it's everything you really need to keep your body working, and keep your energy levels up in the mountains. Now, this is the toughest part of the preparedness part for your body, and that is the mental part. And I, honest to God, I really can't help you with that. It's all you. some people are just more mentally strong than others. It's a fact. I'm telling you what, when it's day 4, day 5 of a hunt, you haven't seen anything, or you haven't even gotten close, or you've had multiple blown stalks, it just gets tougher and tougher to keep that mental focus and your mind on the hunt. You start missing your family, especially if you're way back west. I mean, they're, you know, a couple hundred miles away at least. And you just start thinking if you could be doing something better with your time right now. But you just, you got to keep grinding it out. You got to keep your mind straight, especially if it's slow times in the day. Try to find something to occupy your mind, whether it's taking a hike and glassing new area, or doing push-ups or sit-ups, or reading a book. That is definitely like one of the most important things, is just keep your mind working the whole time so you don't get occupied with something that isn't focused on the hunt. And that's really my mental tips. Everyone's different. You know, some guys can go 10, 15 days and not have a problem. Others can go maybe 2 and start, you know, slowing down and thinking about what they could be doing else, or that they miss their family. So it's all just depending on you. But the thing is, when you come out west, you do have to be prepared for a mental challenge. So just expect that. Expect that you aren't going to see animals every day. Expect that you aren't going, that you're going to have to hike a lot, or expect that you're going to get beaten down physically and mentally. And over the long run, you'll be able to start figuring out what keeps you mentally strong. And so you just keep focusing on that and working on that. And that's, I mean, it's all up to you on the mental game. But, you know, if you figure out that you aren't that mentally strong, you know, early on in the hunt, just remember, you know, it gets better. You finish it out. You know, you paid the money to come out here. You worked so hard in the gym, and you spent so much money on your gear, and just, you know, remember that, and it keeps you focused for the end goal. So that is my mental tip. I know it's probably not that helpful, but like I said, we're all different. So I hope you guys really enjoyed this video. I enjoyed making it. Like I said before, if you have any questions or comments, put them in the comment section below. Don't forget to like this video. I'm having a blast making this series. I get these questions all year round. I answer these questions as best as I can. And hopefully this video answers a lot of your questions. If you have any questions about supplements, you know what? I'm going to just link them in the description below. And I'll put my favorite companies down there and my exact supplement list I use to get prepared for the hunt. If you have any questions about programs, I'll also put a few links down there below and just at least get you started. And so I guess that's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. I really had a ton of fun making it. And do not forget to subscribe so you don't miss these videos. I hope they're helping you guys out, at least get a basic knowledge of what to expect and what to do when you're out west here. And I hope you guys do come out west, and hopefully I see you in the field. So you guys have a great day. Good luck this season, and be safe.